My name is Helen Oxenbury, and I illustrate children's books. And one of my best-known books is We're Going on a Bear Hunt, and I re-illustrated the Alice in Wonderland books by Lewis Carroll. And I think probably I have pretty well 100 books that I have illustrated over the years. I was always drawing as a child, yes. My father was an architect and he encouraged me enormously. And I used to go in for little competitions and things like that. So yes, I was always, from a very early age, drawing. I think probably why I spent so much time drawing was because I was very asthmatic as a child. And I was always away from school. And one of the things that kept me amused while my mother did the housework and whatnot was to do drawing. And of course I grew to love it. I think probably the art teacher was the one who said to my parents, you know, that they ought to send me to art school. And my father was thrilled. I think my mother thought that I ought to be a secretary or something safe like that. But thank goodness my father won and I went to art school. I grew up in a little seaside town on the east coast of England called Felixstowe. So it's a very nice little town with a long wood pier and lovely beach. It was sort of it's Edwardian, all the most of the buildings. And I had the most glorious, free childhood there. My brother and I have one brother, we were let out in the morning and we'd come back maybe for lunch, go out again and come back for tea, and without any restrictions, and we had the whole of this little seaside town and the beach all to ourselves. It was just a wonderful childhood. Books didn't play a large part in my life. I say that, but we didn't own books as a family, because I was brought up during the war, and books were very thin on the ground. But my father used to go to a library and bring me home books, and it was so exciting the days that when he would bring home books, absolutely wonderful. And I can still remember those books, and they weren't good books, I have to say. Probably today they would be considered complete rubbish, but I loved them. They're the only books I had. I was expecting my third child, and a publisher came to me and said he was just starting up a publishing house, and his name was Sebastian Walker, and he said, would you do a book with me? And I said, yes, but not yet. Please just let me have this baby. But I will do something for you a bit later on, which I did. But in the meantime, my daughter had infantile eczema, which is, it keeps you awake at night. Like, you know, you think babies keep you awake at night. When they've got eczema, they really keep you awake at night. And the thing that we did with her was show her catalogues of babies' equipment and babies' clothes and things like that, which she loved, and it stopped her from scratching. So we used to walk up and down all night showing her advertisements and catalogues and things like that. And I thought, well, why isn't there anything really that would be in the shops that would be good? And I thought, right, that's what I'm going to do with this Sebastian Walker, who had come to me and said, would I do something with them? So we started doing a series of board books, which were a huge success, because a lot of people must have been thinking, you know, why aren't there books for babies? So that's how it started. So I did a series of, I can't remember how many, and then I did another series for slightly older, where they just begin to go outside the house and experience other things. And then another set that, when they were sort of preschool, starting their first ballet class, or going to nursery school for the first time. And all that, this time my daughter was growing up at that stage. The only board books I knew before I did mine were the Dick Bruner board books, which were very, very good. And I think the thing about board books, they must be very, very simple, because the experience of babies is just things that they do, their mother, and the food they eat, the clothes they put on, and the pot they're put on. The board books are really, there isn't a story there. It's just objects and babies, and there's one that's called dressing, and really is, it starts off with a little baby in a nappy, and then he gets put, a little vest is put on him, and then little pair of socks. It's just for them to recognize different things that they're familiar with. So you have to keep it down to that level, and actually trying to simplify drawings down to that level is much more difficult than you would think. Very interesting.
For more author interviews, recommended reading lists, and information about teaching kids to read, please visit us online at www.readingrockets.org.